Hello everyone, welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Edupedia. I am Assistant Professor Padma Deshpande. Today I am going to teach the subject Principles of Marketing. This is the SEM 2 of FYBMS class, and in my previous lecture I had told you about the unit 1, that is Introduction to Marketing. In that I had told you about the basics of marketing, what is the difference between marketing and selling, what are the different concepts of marketing, what is the features of marketing, what are the different areas of marketing. All those things we had covered. Today we are going to continue further with our next chapter, that is Marketing Environment, Market Research and Consumer Behavior. So let's begin. First, let's understand what is marketing environment. Marketing environment is a company's all the forces, or it is basically the actors and forces that affect the company's ability to develop and maintain successful transactions and relationships with customers. Now, any business, when it has to survive, it depends on a number of factors. These factors are known as basically environment. A company, when it has to increase its profit, when it has to increase its presence, when the company's brand loyalty, brand presence increases, means what happens? There are certain forces or factors that help in the growth of the company. So all those factors that contribute towards the growth of the company are known as marketing environment. This marketing environment can be broadly classified into two components. What are these components? It comprises of microenvironment and macroenvironment. Now, microenvironment, we also call it as controllable variables, and macroenvironment means non-controllable variables. Controllable variables means to some extent we can make changes or control these factors. And non-controllable variables are those for which we don't have any control. They affect the business of our organization. So let's understand each of this component in detail. In microenvironment, first and foremost is the company itself. Like, company has people working in it. Company has to manage its capital. Company comprises, the capital comprises of fixed capital, working capital. So all this also affect the performance of the organization. The second important factor are the customers. Customers can be consumers, industrial buyers, institutional buyers, resellers, government and other agencies. Now there is a difference between customers and consumers. Customers are those who buy the product and they might sell it. They might reprocess the product and they might sell it. Say for example, a dealer, he purchases goods in wholesale. Then maybe he can add a few he can make a few changes to that product. He can add his own packaging and then resell it. So he is called as a customer. Customer is one who doesn't use the product for his purpose, own purpose, but he may use it for reselling it. Whereas a consumer is one who actually consumes the product for his personal use. Like, you go to the grocery shop and you buy milk or ghee or anything, and what you do is you consume it for yourself. So this is the difference between customer and a consumer. Then there are industrial buyers. Industrial buyers are basically the huge companies who they are the customers, because they reprocess the product and then they sell the product. So industrial buyers can be manufacturers like steel manufacturers, cement manufacturers. All these are industrial buyers. Then there are institutional buyers. Now there are educational institutions. In educational institutions, say for example, there is a big college or a school. In schools, they require benches. So these benches, they will give order to a wholesale manufacturer of wooden benches, and from there they would be buying the benches. So there are institutional buyers. Then there are resellers. Then there are government agencies. Government certain products are sold through the government agencies. So government also are customers for an organization, and there are many small and large middlemen or agents are involved who help in the selling process. So all these are part and parcel of customers. Then there are competitors. Every business firm has competition in the market, may it be a small good or a larger good. Every goods and services has competitors. Because of this competition only, a company has to make changes in its marketing mix. Now, what is marketing mix? Marketing mix is the combination of different factors that the company uses. Like the company in marketing mix, there are four basic components. This marketing mix I had explained to you in my last lecture, that is in your unit 1, first chapter, introduction to marketing. I had told you about 4 P's of marketing and 4 C's of marketing. So what are the 4 P's of marketing? Product, price, place and promotion. So a company, when it has to face its competitors, when it wants to stand in the competition, it makes changes either in the product or in the product with pricing or in the promotional strategies. So there is a presence of competition in the market. Then the fourth aspect are the suppliers. Now suppliers are one who provide the raw material to the manufacturer. For a company, the suppliers are also a part of the chain, important part of the chain, because they provide the raw materials. The suppliers are also called as vendors. Then there are middlemen. Middlemen are those who help in the distribution. Now in 4 P's, the fourth P we call it as place. Product, price, place and promotion. So place, you want your product to reach each and every customer. So how that is possible? It is with the help of middlemen like the dealers, the wholesalers, the retailers, the distributors. They help in making the product available to the customers at different locations. The consumers can buy the products because of the presence of middlemen. Then there are shareholders and stakeholders. Shareholders are ones who have invested money in the company. They have a share in the profit of the company. And the stakeholders, there are other stakeholders like financial institutions. Now in the very beginning I had told about company. The company has to manage with its fixed capital and the working capital. So in the financial institutions help the company for raising up finance. The financial institutions give loan facility to the companies. The financial institutions give overdraft facility to the company. The financial institutions help in financing new projects, new ventures. So financial institutions are also an integral part or integral stakeholder for an organization. Similarly, the creditors. The creditors are the ones who give money to the company. The creditors are the one who help in the rotation of finance. So they are also an important part. Then the media. Now, media is very important because media plays a major role in the promotion of the goods and services in the society. The media creates a positive or a negative image of the organization in front of the customers or the consumers. So media is also an integral part of the stakeholders. Then there are government agencies. The government formulates different taxes, environmental laws. There is MRTP Act. So many rules and regulations have been formulated. Why? This is for the protection of the consumers. So the companies have to follow the norms, the rules and regulations what the government has prescribed, and the companies also have to pay taxes to the government in the form of corporate taxes. Now this taxes money is utilized by the government for the infrastructural development. For a company to grow, it requires infrastructure. So this infrastructure is built by the government based on the finance that it gets from all the different sources, that the different corporates, when they pay the taxes regularly, the government is able to raise finance, and then it spends this finance or money on the infrastructure development. Then there are citizen groups. Now every organization is set up in a society. So every organization has certain responsibility towards the society. That is, they should avoid adulteration. They should avoid, you know, they should not, the prices of the products should not, artificial prices of the products should not be changed drastically. There should, they should not create artificial scarcity. Then consumers should not be exploited. So there are citizen groups which ensure that the consumers are not exploited. So all these are the internal variables, or we also call it as the controllable variables, which are part of the micro environment. The macro environment is called as the external environment. In short, we call it as pest analysis also, or we also call it as pestil analysis. Now, pestil comprises of political, economical, social, technological, legal, and environmental environment. So all these factors, external factors, are also part of the components of marketing environment. The first environment that affects a business is the demographic environment. Now, demographic environment means the number of consumers that are present in a particular area. What is their age group, their gender classification, the income capacity of the people, the purchasing capacity of the people, where they are located, the buying patterns of the people, what do they buy, when do they buy, how do they buy, what are the different promotion strategies we will have to formulate, how we are going to do the distribution of the product. Because in the demography is, as I told you, it's a composition of people. So in composition of people, there might be young children, there might be adults, there might be old age people, there might be youngsters. So every area has a composition of different age group of people. So the promotional strategy, all these things have to be decided according to the target, the age group which we are going to target. So the demographic environment is a part of external environment. The second environment that affects the organization, or as an integral role in the organization, is the economic environment. Economic environment basically comprises of how the market position is, whether there is a boom in the market, whether there is a recession in the market, what are the different policies that are formulated by the government. The government brings in certain taxation policies. Abhi samjo, say for example GST aa gaya, ya fir what is the economic system of the country, what is the exchange value of the of our currency. All these are the part and parcel of economic environment. The third environment comprises of the natural resources. How rich your country is with its resources. What are the resources that are available in abundant with the country? What are the environmental laws? In a number of countries, there are a lot of environmental laws are also have to be followed in that country. So natural environment is also an important aspect of the macro environment. Then the technological environment. Friends, you all know that technology has progressed a lot. Today, at the tip of the finger, you have all the things available to you. So any country adopts all the technological practices, which adjusts itself to the new technology, can grow in a faster pace. Now, India is a developing economy. So today we have also adopted ourselves to the changing economic technological scenario. However, there are a number of developed countries who are already quite advanced in the technological progress. We are still lagging behind in a number of aspects, but still technological environment also affects the performance of a business organization, because the more the advanced technology will use, the superior quality of products will be produced, and these products can be sold in the market. So technological environment has an impact on the performance of an organization. The next aspect that affects the company is the political environment. Political environment basically comprises of the composition of the policies that are there, the government that exists. There are some countries follow the democracy policies. Some countries have communist rule. So all this also affects the business performance. In certain countries, the private firms do not have any freedom. Everything is controlled by the government, and all the trade and everything is controlled by the government, and the government takes all the decisions. Whereas in a democratic country like India, there is a lot of freedom given for the businessmen to do the trade. The trade policies are also formulated in such a way that they are beneficial for all. So the next environment that affects is the socio-cultural environment. Socio-cultural environment basically comprises of the religion that is followed in a country, the cultural values that the people carry. Because what happens is in India we have majority of Hinduism. In the world over, the major religions that are followed is Christianity, then Islam religion is followed, then Buddhism is followed, and then Hinduism is followed. So the cultural environment also impacts the performance of the business, and when it has to formulate the strategies, it has to take in consideration the socio-cultural background of the people. As I told you, demographic environment is an important integral part. So in the demography, the socio-cultural environment comes in. That is the reason why McDonald's in India is offered as a burger which is having a patty of either it is a potato patty or it can be maximum chicken patty is used. Whereas in the foreign countries, beef and pork is also used for making the patties. So this depends on the socio-cultural background. So a business organization has to consider or take care of the socio-cultural environment. Then the international environment. Today, because of technology, advancement of technology, because of liberalization, because of globalization, the world market has opened, and with the opening of the world market, trade is taking place on a very large scale. With the increase in trade, new institutions like the World Trade Organization came into existence. This World Trade Organization has formulated a number of trade agreements, trade policies, export trade methods. They have, from time to time, they have set up a number of guidelines. They have introduced TRIPS and TRIMS. TRIPS is related to the patent law. TRIMS is related to the investment law aspects. When you want to do international investments, finance, deal in finance and all those things. So all those things have to, the international finance, the international marketing, all these things are gaining a lot of importance. Then the last aspect comes is the legal environment. Now, any business organization has to follow a number of laws, like there is Competition Act is there, then MRTP Act is there, FEMA is there, Foreign Exchange Management Act is there, then Weights and Measures Act is there, Consumer Protection Act is there, Drugs and Cosmetics Act is there, Factories Act is there. So all these are the legal laws or policies which any business organization has to follow. So these are the basic micro and macro environment. The next aspect that I'm going to tell you about is marketing research. Now, what is research? Research is a systematic analysis of a problem. Now, say for example, why a particular product is not performing in a particular region, or why there is why the profits of the organization have reduced. This is a problem which is faced by the organization, and it is very important that you find a solution to that problem. So what we do is we do our research. So that's why marketing research is a systematic process of what? Of identifying, designing, collecting data, processing the data, analyzing it, and interpreting, or we come with a solution. It is very specific in nature. Why? Because we are trying to solve a particular problem. It can cover like product research. In that, the features or the changes can be brought about in the product or in the packaging, or what changes do we need to make in the publicity or advertising, or what are the pricing strategies, how it is affecting the corporate image, or we can also do a research on the place. It is an applied research. Why we say it is an applied research? Because we are trying to find a solution to a problem. हमको हम फाइंड आउट करना है कि हमारा सेल्स पर्टिकुलरली क्यों कम हो रहा है, तो उसके लिए हम रिसर्च कर रहे हैं. वी आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड अ सॉल्यूशन टू अ प्रॉब्लम. रिसर्च से वी कैन ब्रिज अ कंपनी कैन ब्रिज द गैप बिटवीन द कंज्यूमर एंड द कंपनी. रिसर्च इज अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फॉर अंडरटेकिंग रिसर्च इज टू इंक्रीज इट्स शेयर, इंक्रीज द प्रॉफिट एंड टेक कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव डिसीजन. इट इज अ प्रोफेशनल अप्रोच बिकॉज देर शुड बी अ वेल क्वालिफाइड टीम हु आर अवेयर हाउ वॉट इज रिसर्च, वॉट वी नीड टू फाइंड. Proper training needs to be given to the people. They should be made to understand why they are doing this research, what from the outcome, what all things is possible. Then on the basis of research, marketing decisions, that is the marketing mix decision, that is the changes in the four P's can be taken. It is a step-by-step process in which there is secondary data and primary data is collected. And this data can be collected through surveys, interviews, experimentations. Now, what is secondary data? Secondary data is already the records that is available with the organization, the reports that are generated, the government publications that are available. All this is the part of the secondary data. And primary data comprises of when you do a survey or when you do an interview, when you observe something, you make a notation of that. You ask, when you take an interview, you ask a series of questions to your consumers, to your dealers, and from that you come to get a number of suggestions, you get a lot of information. So all this becomes primary data. And research is having certain limitations because it requires lot of time, funds are required. So marketing research is important for making marketing mix decisions. It is important because the needs of the customers are changing, the preferences of the customers are changing. If you want to satisfy the customer, then you need to identify what are the changes in the customer preferences. With the help of marketing research, company can take a competitive advantage, its corporate image can improve, the sales of the company can improve, the markets of the company can be expanded, you can have better dealers relationship, then the brand loyalty of the organization can be increased, there can be optimum utilization of resources, and the organizational objective, that is to increase the market share, to increase its brand value, to increase its corporate image, all these things can be fully covered with the help of marketing research. So that's why marketing research is to be given importance by the organization. So today I basically have covered what is marketing environment and what is marketing research. Marketing research is undertaken in the areas of consumers. It is undertaken in the area of dealers, like what are the consumers' needs, wants, what are the expectations. Dealer research is what type of promotional strategies or how we are going to, how we can push the dealers to sell our products more. What are the features or added changes, what is the expectation of the customer with regards to quality of product, all that can be done in the product research. Pricing research is what changes need to be made in the pricing of the product. Market research is basically what the current market is, whether the pricing is proper to the current market requirement, whether our customers are happy with our promotional strategy, whether our dealers are happy with the incentives that we are given. All these things are covered under the market research. And in sales research, we try to find out in a particular area what is the sales, in a particular area why the sales has dropped, what can be the reasons, what additional promotional strategies do we need to re-strategize. All these things can be understood through sales research. So these are the different areas of marketing research. So primarily today I have completed what is market environment. Market environment comprises of micro and macro environment, and I have told you in detail about marketing research. In my next video, I'll be coming with the topic MIS, that is marketing information system and consumer behavior. Till then, all of y'all stay connected, stay safe. Thank you.